Guys, we are back again. Welcome to my YouTube channel. And on today's tutorial, we want to look at how to calculate the quantity of steel, that is reinforcement bars in a slab. So we are going to look at mainly the main bars and the distribution bars. Those are the types of bars that we have in our slab. So if you are new to this channel, kindly subscribe, share, and leave a comment. So we are going to proceed straight to our slab. So we said in a slab we have the main bars and the distribution bars. We are going to look at the difference between the two. If you can look at this drawing here, this is our slab. We have the horizontal and the vertical. So our main bars are the ones that are running this way, the vertical ones along the longer span, and then our distribution bars are these ones that are running horizontal along the span. So those are the two bars. The main reinforcement bar is used at the bottom of the slab, while the distribution bars are placed on top of the main bars. So we have the main bar, and then on top of it we'll put our distribution bars. Main bar is used in shorter direction, but the distribution bars is used in the longer span. So the main bar is used in this shorter span, and then the distribution is used in the longer span. Main reinforcement bar is used to transfer the bending moments to beams, but the distribution bars are used to resist the shear stress, cracks developed at the top of the slab. So those are the difference between the main bars and the distribution bar. So we shall look at how to calculate the quantity of those steel in a slab. Now guys, this is our slab. So our slab is 500 millimeters long and 2000 millimeters wide, and then we have the main bars here, 12 millimeters diameter at a spacing of 150 millimeters center to center. And then our distribution bars, these ones here, yeah, these are our distribution bars. They are 8 millimeters at 150 millimeters center to center, and then we have clear cover is 25 millimeters, and then the slab thickness is 150. The clear cover here, we are talking about this distance from this point to this point, from this point to this point, and from this point to this point, and the same as from this point up to this point, because our reinforcement are not going to go to the edges of the formwork, so they must leave a space here. So that is what we call cover, that space that is on the entire slab. Now that we have the details, let's proceed and calculate the number of the main bars and the number of the distribution bars. So the number of the main bars will be total length minus clear cover plus one. So our total length is 5000, that is 5000. Our clear length is 25 millimeters, so we multiply 25 by 2, and then our spacing is 150 plus 1. So it's 5000 because the main bars are these ones that are running there. Yeah, those ones are the main bars. Now they are running along the span of 5000. So when we tabulate that one, we get that four bars. For the distribution bars, it's going to be also the total length minus clear cover plus one. So our total length, that is the width, it's 2000 minus clear span minus clear cover, sorry, that is 225, and then we divide by 150, that gives us 14 bars. Now guys, our main bars are 34 and our distribution bars are 14. So we are going to proceed to another element whereby we want to know how long are we, how long is the reinforcement from this point up to this point, including the bend and the hooks. Remember, our reinforcement goes that way for the slab, and then if it is for the main bars, we have a bend, and then we have the hook. So we want to know how long is this entire cutting from this point up to there, then that one, and then the bar itself. Same for the distribution bars, because that is how they are placed. So you want to know what is the cutting length. Now for the main bars, the formula is L plus 2 into LD plus into 1 times 0.42D minus 2 times 1D, where L is the clear span, LD is the development length, which is equal to 40D, whereby D is the diameter, and then 0.2D is the inclined length, and then we have 1D, which is equivalent to 45 degrees bend. So first we should calculate the length, that is D. We start by getting the D. D is the thickness of the slab minus 2 clear cover, that is for the top and the bottom, minus the diameter of the bar. Tabulating that, the thickness is 150, the cover is 25, that is 225, minus the diameter is 12. Tabulating that one, we get 88 millimeters. So that is our D. Now let's insert the figures into the formula, and then we get the cutting length. So when we insert the figures into the formula, that is what we have, and then we tabulate that one, our cutting length will be 2972.96 millimeters, that is 2.96 meters. So for the main bar, this bar here that we are going to cut, we are going to cut a length of 2.97 meters for it to be able to fit that area, that space. And then for the distribution bar, the formula for cutting length is clear span plus 2 times the development length. Remember, the development is 40D, whereby D is the diameter. In this case, our diameter is 8. So our clear span is 5000, and then plus 2 times 14 times 8, that gives us, tabulating that one, it gives us 5640 or 5.64. So that is the length that we need for this bar. From this point, we are going to bend it that way, and then it joins that way, going along, and then this side also. So that entire bar is 5.64 meters. So in conclusion, what we need for that slab of 500 millimeters by 2000 millimeter will be, the number of bars is 34 for the main bars, and then the length of one bar is 2.97 meters, that gives us 100.98 millimeters. This is now for the main bars, that is a 12 millimeters diameter bar. For the distribution bars, we have 14. The length of one is 5.64. So tabulating that, the total length of steel that we'll need for the D 8 millimeters is 78.96. So guys, that is how quickly you calculate the quantity of steel in a slab. Until next time, bye bye.